Welcome back. Give me one moment to finish this calculation and we can begin our lesson. And done. Finally. That took way longer than I expected. Maybe I should have waited until after this lesson so B could show me how to make a spreadsheet to do my math for me. If you like the idea of a computer program doing all of your calculations and making charts instead of you having to do all the work, then this video is for you. By the end of this lesson, you will be able to use spreadsheet software to perform automatic calculations and create charts. Let's get into it.
Hey, it's B again, here to show you the true power behind spreadsheet software. Let's continue working with our data from before. Let's say we wanted to find the total age of everyone we've listed here. In a spreadsheet, in order to perform a calculation, you have to start the cell's text with an equals sign, which tells it that the cell's value is equal to a calculation. Then we type the math we want to do, 13 plus 17 plus 26, on and on until we've included everybody's age. When we finish and press enter, it performs the addition for us and shows the result as if we had typed it in. Any math for which you manually type in the operations, like the addition signs here, are known as formulas. If you select that cell again, the formula bar will show you the formula that is creating the cell's value. But ages change, don't they? Each year, everyone you listed will get older, and you can keep changing their ages in your spreadsheet. But the total isn't changing. That's because the age being added for each person isn't going up when their actual age is. You could try to remember to update their age in both places, but there's an easier way. So instead, let's rewrite the formula. Instead of adding specific numbers, we can tell the spreadsheet to use the value in cell B2 simply by writing that cell's name as part of our formula. This is known as referencing the other cell. An easy way to reference cells without having to figure out their names is simply to click on them while you're working on a formula. The name of that cell will be inserted automatically. So B2 plus, and then click on B3, plus B4, on and on, until we've included every cell. We end up with the correct total, but watch this. On Molly's birthday, her age increases, and the total went up by 1 as well. The total will automatically update anytime somebody gets older, because instead of specific numbers, we told it to add whatever values are in specific cells. But don't forget, spreadsheets are commonly used for large sets of data. Like, imagine if you had 100 friends and family members to keep track of. Do you want to sit at a computer and add each age one by one? Referencing cells wouldn't change how long that would take. Luckily, there's a much quicker way by using functions. Functions are pre-coded formulas that don't require you to type operations or select individual cells. For instance, if you want the sum of all these ages, you can type equals sum, then choose sum from the drop-down. Now we just need to tell it which cells we want to sum up. Drag to highlight the entire range of ages, from the first age to the last, and then hit enter. Just like that, we have the total of all the ages. it will update automatically since we made it by referencing cells. And it took basically no time at all because we used a function instead of a formula. The last important use of spreadsheets is their ability to create charts out of raw data. Take our age data, for instance. If we want to make a nice chart showing the ages of the people in our lives, we highlight the data, then go to the Insert menu and choose Chart. A pie chart doesn't seem right here. The problem is, you have to know what kind of chart fits your data. Pie charts are used to display parts of a whole. In this case, how much each person in our list contributes to the total age. That doesn't seem helpful to know. Line charts are used to compare two sets of data to see how they affect each other. But comparing people's names to their ages isn't super helpful either. So what type of chart would be good for this data? Oh, here we go! A histogram will show how many of our friends and family are in different age groups. In other words, how their ages are distributed. Wow, I never realized I don't have any friends between 22 and 28. Once you've figured out what kind of graph you need, you can customize it however you want. Create your own chart. And then play around with the customization options. You can even copy these charts into documents and presentations. All you have to do is select the chart, use your computer's copy keyboard shortcut, like Control-C, then switch to your presentation and use your computer's paste shortcut, like Control-V. And voila! Now your professional-looking presentation includes a professional-looking chart to match.
Wow! I never realized how much I was missing out on by not using spreadsheet software. Now that you know the tools at your disposal, the only thing left to do is experiment with them. The PDF for this lesson includes suggestions for practice projects that will help you hone your skills with using spreadsheet software. You can choose some of these mini projects to do, come up with your own projects you'd like to try out, or play around on spreadsheet software without a specific goal in mind. Once you think you've mastered spreadsheet software, you can move on to the wrap-up for this unit, which includes a review guide, a few more project ideas for additional practice, and the unit assessment. Then you'll be ready to move on to the next unit, where we'll finally be taking things online and learning about different internet software that can be used for communication with people all over the world. Until then, remember, your brain is the smartest computer you'll ever have, so keep it charged and never stop updating it. See you next time! Hey, hey.